Hey guys, it's Will. Hopefully you're having a great day today. In this video, we're going to go over one of the top space companies in the world, which is RocketLab. Now, I have a friend that works at RocketLab, and we've seen a lot of growth since back when I used to live with this friend in Colorado. He was working at a space company while I was working at an institution in Boulder, Colorado. And I remember getting introduced to this stock around $3 a share. And another friend who I know, his name's Adam. He works at a Roblox, I believe it is, as a visual designer in San Francisco. And I remember, you know, us talking about and starting to invest in RocketLab around $3 a share. And now we've seen RocketLab surge. Now there's a reason why it's at $46 a share now. And there's also some reasons why RocketLab could continue to see its momentum play out into the coming years, and why it's not just an overvalued play in the grand scheme of things. So right now you can see it's got up to that $55 range. They are, for those of you guys that aren't familiar, they're an end-to-end space company. So they work on the rockets, they build carbon composite and carbon fiber materials into their rockets, so they're really light. It's a little more expensive, but the reason it's valuable is because it saves on the payload. They don't have to use as much energy to launch these rockets. And they're really a competitor with SpaceX. So they've launched over 238 satellites with their Electron rocket. They have 1,700 satellites on orbit with RocketLab technology. So as we mentioned, they're cumulative. And they got 150 plus years in space for RocketLab technology. Cumulative years in experience. And so when we say end to end, it means they're working from the deployments to the software to the solar cells down to the semiconductors, even for the technology that's in their rockets. They build the rockets in their entirety. Now, this does a few things. First, it allows them to build rocket components that are purchased by other companies. So they end up selling and having and controlling their own manufacturing to other parties that are looking to build. So the other thing that they have as an advantage recently is that they're one of these space companies that has actually seen their financials continue to grow. Now their market cap's at $22 billion. And I remember when they were under a billion. This market cap of $22 billion, when you look at the current prices, it's also important to realize the market of space tech. Some people see this $22 billion figure and they say, okay, they're bringing in $150 million in revenue per quarter annually. We see them increase their revenue. Yeah, it looks like they're on track to maybe hit $600 million in revenue this next year, which is, again, about a 50 to 70% increases in revenue year over year. So they're increasing their revenue. But come on, Will, a $22 billion valuation, this is why they're valued where they are and why they may continue. And there's a lot of articles now, which we don't want to put too much weight on because, you know, there's a lot of hype on the internet. But you can see, like, there's a lot of targets with RocketLab going to $100. And even when I asked my friend who works at RocketLab now, I was just met up with him a couple weeks ago in LA, which we'll be going back to LA sometime soon to do some stuff related to Robinhood. But I was at an all-in podcast or event summit thing that we went and saw some of the aftermath of in LA with my friend, and he works over in Long Beach for RocketLab. And even now, when I was talking to him, he said, you know, we're doing some really cool stuff. It's still one of his top favorite holdings. And I thought that's really cool. This is coming from an investor and friend of mine that also, we started looking at Tesla, and he started investing it when it was $30 a share back in, 2013 or something like that. So anyway, when it comes to this company, what you need to know about why they could continue to surge in market cap, it's because if you look at a company like SpaceX, which runs their satellites, they launch for other companies as well, and they also run Starlink. SpaceX is valued at around $300 billion, okay? So right now, RocketLab is catching up in the frequency of their launches, and they're still only about less than one-tenth, only about 5 to 8% of the size of SpaceX from a market cap perspective, and they're a publicly traded company, unlike SpaceX. I believe if SpaceX was publicly traded, they would probably have a larger market cap than they're at currently, just because of public markets and the volume that they would see. So I think market cap wise for Rocket Lab, this is just the start. We're going to see them go further down the road. Now, doesn't mean we won't see rocky slopes on the way there. In fact, when you look at some of their financials and they have the runway, they look pretty solid. They're still, when we look at their chart, they're up to all-time highs recently, just this past week, up to $55 a share. So when we look at the drawings, kind of what we've seen, they have this trajectory, which is really good, just this consistent build of market cap. See all that value that they're filling up to here? And it's good, but they do oftentimes, they have this level that they established, a previous resistance, a rising trend in which they're selling back down, potentially in this $42, $43 range. And they could continue up in this direction and break out to even higher highs faster. But we could also see, you know, just the overall direction, maybe it experiences a pullback down to this $35 or $40 range here. Quite possible. But overall direction for Rocket Lab in the long term looks excellent. Now, in the short term, we have seen holders increase by 344 with decreased positions only at 196. When it comes to institutional ownership, there's more investments coming in for Rocket Lab. You do see some of the top holders right now, including BlackRock, Vanguard. We see State Street there, as well as Bank of America. And they're continuing to invest in Rocket Lab. So what does that mean? Well, personally, I'm going to continue to hold and add to positions for Rocket Lab for the long term. I think this is a stock that space tech is a unique market. It's hard to compete. It's a lot of startup costs. And with Rocket Lab's end-to-end approach with building their rockets and servicing many other companies, even getting some massive deals with NASA. I think it was a Mars launch where NASA said, we're looking to do this Mars launch and it's going to cost $15 billion or something. Rocket Lab came in and said, oh, you don't need to spend $15 billion. We can do it for $8 billion or we can do it for $5 billion. Because we have all the infrastructure set up to do that, and they proved it, and they ended up securing many more NASA contracts. So you can look at some of their missions. If you look at their past missions that they've launched, they've been launching for NASA, they've been launching for Black Sky, so AI-driven analytics, Canis, which is kind of a competitor there with Starlink. I believe they're doing like internet down to Earth from space. And then, of course, you have some NASA missions here. You know, and this is just getting into like 2025 as they continue to ramp up some of the launches here. Basically, 1 to 3 per month, sometimes as many as 5 per month, we're seeing them launch for other companies that are paying them for those launches. So really looking good on the long term. Again, short term, we're looking at this level here. If we see the markets continue with some bullish momentum, as we have seen, then the next target for Rocket Lab would be back up into this range, probably around $53 to $55 a share, and continuing that range in that 10 to 20% margin for profit, if they can hold that level. Now, we'll also watch here, see how they react throughout the day, as managing risk would probably come right around this $43 price point, as that's also a key level of support there in their trend, where we would want to see them hold that level. As if they couldn't, there's another support at 41, and then potentially, you know, staying in their trend, but conservatively, the ultra conservative move would be seeing a sell down here to 33, 35 bucks before then. But I think they're a good long term. I'm going to continue to add to them. And then short term, we love to trade it when the opportunities present themselves. If you'd ever like to see us trade live, we do go live at Market Open every day, Monday through Friday at 6:30 a.m. Pacific time. It's pretty early in the morning, but if you'd like to join us there, we're going to have the targets for this week coming out, as we come out with targets every single week, along with all of the earnings of companies when they're reporting. And then you can see our entries, see our exits in our trades at our live session in Market Open. And if you want to join us live, it's a second link below to join StockMate. The other thing that we've been building recently is over here. We can go RKLB and I can get some analysis here from, let's say, OpenAI. And it's looking at all the financials. It's looking at the news. It's looking at their launches. It's looking at the insider holdings, institutional buying. All of those things are being considered. And then it's essentially giving us a projection for RocketLab right now. So if you want to get your hands on this tool, there's a full breakdown in how to use AI. We recently did a recording. And if you'd like to tune in, see how to use this AI tool that we've developed. And if you want to grab that model and learn how to use the AI, it's the first link in the description. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully I earned your thumbs up. Comment your thoughts on RocketLab down below. And I'll see you in the next video. Take care.